guys. How's it going? Hope you've been well. We're here with day three. As you probably saw in the last episode, we got a little dirty yesterday and we're doing a lot of high speed stuff. Today we're slowing it down, doing a little rock crawling type stuff on the rim trail, and hopefully it's gonna be an awesome day. I don't know how gnarly it's gonna be, but I'd like to be at lower tire pressure for it. So Adam actually had a few air down tools in his truck. These little guys, I don't know what brand or whatever they are.
Yeah, they're a pretty simple device. You can kind of preset your PSI, and when it reaches that PSI, it stops.
So yeah, you just screw it onto the valve stem and it starts letting out air. We do have a little tire pressure gauge as well, so probably gonna take it down to just like 15 PSI.
Well, I guess the final test is a little rock crawling.
We'll see how she does. Yes, we're climbing up this thing a little bit.
There it is. That's pretty good incline. You're in four low, I'm guessing now.
I'm in four low now, yeah, and I'm in sport mode to just kind of keep myself in first gear, because the automatic trannies might want to bump you up, but I want that,
stay
low speed torque.
Keep it in manual, keep it in first, four
yeah,
low.
Depending on how fast you're going, obviously. And then the terrain out in Moab, the rock is exceptionally grippy, which is mostly
it's like sandpaper.
Yeah, mostly good, but sometimes makes you a little overconfident. So when you get on super off-camber stuff, your front end's in the air, you can over-torque it to really bring that top end up a little more than you would want to. So it can get a little sketchy at times. So here we're going to want to hug this right side as close as we can.
Okay. There you go.
Good?
Yeah. There you go. Still got about a foot on your left. Nice.
All right.
Now you got a big drop. Beautiful. Oh, yeah.
And then here's probably, we're coming up on the scariest portion. We're gonna get a little off camber.
I like the sound of off camber. Oh, good lord.
How you feeling?
Oh my lord.
You good? Good on that side?
Yeah, you got plenty of room. Plenty of room. Oh, Mike, don't kill me, please. Okay, you might straighten out just so you don't scrape. You good? Oh, yeah.
Oh man, unfortunately I think this is where the trail ends for us today.
Guys, this ledge looks virtually impassable.
It is basically just a wall that we will ram into. So we could build up some rocks and get over it and continue on, but we got some tacos to get to. So.
I'm getting hungry anyway, maybe we should just head back. Here we've got some beautiful bison meat. So because this meat's partially frozen, it's gonna help me slice it super thin. See that? You couldn't do that with a completely raw piece of beef.
Pastrami almost.
Yeah, we're getting a nice sort of brunoise is what we would call that. We pop it in that bag. Well, let's add salt, lots of paprika. I love that stuff. Gives the oil a nice color. And this is cumin. Cumin's that kind of classic taco flavor, if you will. Rounds of jalapeno. Here I'm gonna take a part of bell pepper. Take the top off, take the bottom off, hit it down the side, lay it down, and just give it a little roll. See that? That's how you clean a bell pepper.
That was nice.
Pretty cool, huh? And I'll do it again. And now we have a nice little dice. See that? Finally, I want to add a little bit of onion. We have all that beautiful mixture. We're going to go right into some hot oil. We want caramelization. One pot cookery, this is the best kind.
Less mess, less cleanup.
That's right, sir. I'll throw a little bit of avocado down at the bottom.
Can you grab the cilantro?
Right there, sort of a street style taco. Put a little extra avocado on top, just for that look, you know? Mm. That crunchy bison, a little local meat. A little onion, a little pepper.
That's delicious.
You're supposed to wait 30 minutes after you eat to go swimming. I think you're supposed to wait 30 minutes after you eat to go four-wheeling.
I think that's the first time I had bison tacos, actually.
Was it?
Yeah.
Yeah, man. Bison meat, it's very similar to beef, but You know, it's got that little bit extra of something, that little extra flavor.
Well, you've been doing your job of cooking. Now it's my turn to rip us around the mountains without killing us.
I love this sort of valley we're going through.
I mean, this is like total Hollywood movie Mad Western. Max vibe.
Totally. I see John Wayne riding up to the end of one of these.
So I figured it'd be appropriate to kind of end the journey going through a pass that is actually called Pucker.
What's the pucker element that you'd end up with a boulder on top of your truck?
I guess we'll find out. Awesome that you could see where that giant boulder just separated itself from the cliff.
It just broke off. Good thing we weren't on the trail at that time. It makes for such a great photo.
Yeah, it's beautiful, and the lighting on that thing. Woo.
Getting close to the ridge, though. Hopefully we can get there before sunset.
Yeah, I think we got it.
Well, Mike, you did it again, bud.
Just keep one-upping ourselves every night.
This is too cool, man.
Woo! This is my favorite view of the trip.
I'll tell you what, dude, this has been one epic adventure.
Couldn't have done it without you.
Likewise. You know, I kept you fed and you kept me entertained.
I promise I'll put more effort into my cooking.
I appreciate that. Maybe less Lunchables and a couple more frozen steaks.
Yeah.
Look at this, man. This is as good as it gets.
All right, that was an awesome 3 days. Thanks so much to the crew, who you guys don't see behind you, but there's a lot that went into this. So thanks to them, and thanks to Toyota for making this happen. But we are gonna air back up and get on out of here. So until next time, guys, take care.